I see my name in shiny lights. Yeah, a different city every night. Oh, I swear the world better prepare for when I'm a billionaire.
It's time to get down to business on the weekend's number one business program. Known as the King of Networking, your host, Shalom Klein, has worked with thousands of entrepreneurs and created countless jobs. So, to success, let's get down to business.
And indeed, we're all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship and business. We talk a lot about business here. You're on with Get Down to Business, and I'm your host, Shalom Klein. Remember, you can always download podcasts from Get Down to Business on my website at shalomklein.com. And while you're there, don't forget to follow me on Twitter at Shalom Klein. It's going to be a jam-packed week of content and information you will not want to miss. So let's jump right in. I'm thrilled to be joined by Brian Smith, who's the founder and senior managing partner of IA Business Advisors, a management consulting firm that has worked with more than 18,000, that's right, 18,000 CEOs, entrepreneurs, managers, and employees worldwide. And together with his daughter, Mary Griffin, he's authored his latest book, Individual Influence, Find the I in Team. And I'm thrilled to be joined once again by Brian Smith. Brian, welcome to the program.
Thank you. Thanks a lot for having me.
Absolutely. So, you know, it's really, really interesting. I think a lot about goal setting at this time of year as we're wrapping up 2022. But, you know, I know you talk in the book how goals are abstract because they're rooted in the future, while intentions focus on the present. So we're going to, again, talk all about your book over here, which is a fascinating read, Individual Influence, Find the I in Team, where you sort of share how to become your better self with everyone who you influence. So Brian, let's start by talking about how you became so passionate about this topic and your career, which is quite fascinating and impressive indeed.
Well, thanks. Yeah. The book came out of our body of work, which was an evolution of installing ERP or accounting systems back in the 90s when they started to be put on our desktops, especially in small business desktops. And what was happening to our ability as humans to focus on the speed of business as it increased, and identifying new things like technology-induced attention deficit disorder and how that got in the way of goal settings, being in the present moment, realizing our influence and what getting out of that moment does to us. So you're right. We believe in goal setting and intention, but we kind of want everybody to slow it down to refocus on themselves, not just the technology and the speed of business.
Okay, fantastic. So I know that the book is not just a book. It's really, it's part of a series, the I in Team series. So why did you get started in that? And I'm curious, how did you and your daughter get into this process? Because that's not often that we talk about teamwork in a successful way as it relates to family businesses.
Yeah, so, you know, our belief is that our influence as humans is our greatest responsibility. And that influence obviously came out of what I just said. Mary was graduating school, her degrees in English Lit and psychology. I asked her to help me from an editorial perspective, but growing up in this environment, I started the company in 96. She was born in 94, so she grew up in this environment of understanding influence and self. And as we went through that process, she became more and more passionate and more involved in our work. And instead of just being an editor, she now helps write for our book, write for our blogs, and prepare the I and Team series for the future as we move through each aspect of it.
That's great. That's great. You're listening to Get Down to Business, and I'm chatting with Dr. Brian Smith, founder and senior managing partner of IA Business Advisors, and the co-author of a fantastic new read called Individual Influence, Find the I in Team. So with that word influence, you know, we talk a lot about the folks that have the big names, today's influencers. What do you think about today's influencers? Are they people that we should be proud of and sort of highlighting out in today's culture?
So obviously that's very subjective. Those of us who agree with them would say yes, and those of us who don't would say no. The point of our book is we all have influence within whatever area of influence we live in the present moment. So our books are about slowing our lives down and understanding what our individual influence is, where it comes from, how we manage that influence, and what we do with it. And the series is about that, really, and making each of us aware of our influence and doing the best we can to be a positive influence. And yes, some of those people will be a positive influence on us and some will be a negative, but managing what that does to us is really important.
Okay, so let's break out those words influence and let's talk about leadership. What makes a good leader? And specifically, as we talk to a business community here, both in Chicago and around the world, who makes a great leader?
So to us, the person that makes a great leader is somebody who actually understands the influence they have and can provide that influence in a positive way to anybody that they're responsible for. And responsibility doesn't necessarily mean in charge of. It could be in support of. And support comes in so many different ways. Mentorship or just as an assistant to somebody. But we're an accumulation of all of the influence up to this moment. So as a human being that has influence and has to do things to move us forward, the best leaders understand that and understand where it's taking them each step of the way.
Very interesting. Okay, great. So again, sticking with that sort of business theme as it relates to leadership, what is the future of leadership? What are some of the things that as we have this conversation in late 2022, that sort of maybe things have changed during your period of time, and especially watching your daughter as your co-author of this fantastic read, Individual Influence, Find the I in Team. What has changed?
Well, I think we're seeing flatter hierarchy in organizations where there's still levels of responsibility and levels of decision making, but we're seeing things like accountability become more mindful as humans. Discussions about culture, discussions about human interaction, discussions about better communication, not just goal setting, but what do we do with those goals? How do we tactically reach those goals, and what's the milestones in between? These are all coming to light even faster as we moved into a decentralized work environment, working remotely, trying to manage people remotely. We have to rely on humans to be more decisive, be more inclusive, and to take responsibility for the decisions and the influence that they have.
Well, we're running out of time. And again, I've been chatting with Dr. Brian Smith, founder and senior managing partner of IA Business Advisors, who together with his daughter, Mary Griffin, has co-authored their latest book, Individual Influence, Find the I in Team. And I know, Brian, you've worked with over 18,000 CEOs, entrepreneurs, managers, and employees worldwide. So why do you feel now is the right time to redefine the I in individual?
Well, individual is so much greater than just one. Our definition of individual is obviously me, myself. But when I work with you or the people in our organization towards a common goal, we are individual working towards a common goal. And so we feel that because of what's happened in the world, this decentralized work environment, these islands we can be placed on, understanding what individual means and the influence we have, whatever that definition is at the moment, is the right thing to understand now.
Oh, that's great, Brian. You've shared a lot with us, and I certainly come away with a greater understanding of, again, those goals as we've talked about the influence and certainly your perspective of leadership, which is very helpful. I always leave people with a takeaway, and I think perhaps the best takeaway would be picking up a copy of the book. So I want to make sure our listeners know how they can get in touch with you, Brian. How can we find the book and how can we get in contact?
So our book's available at Amazon, Barnes & Noble. Those are the two best places to get it. You can go to our website, iabusinessadvisors.com, and follow us there. We have a newsletter. We have a regular blog. We also are very active on social, on LinkedIn, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter, where we push a lot of content and a lot of information about not just us, but what our peers are doing in this same space.
Well, that's great, Brian. I really appreciate you sharing your expertise with all of our listeners. Great conversation, especially as we come to the conclusion of 2022, and we're all looking to sort of step up and have our goals in mind and figure out how we're going to have influence, whether it's internally within our own organizations or externally as well. So great advice indeed. Thank you so much for joining us, Brian Smith. And we've got to squeeze in a quick break here on the show all about small business jobs and entrepreneurship. But you can always get on my website, shalomklein.com, and you can subscribe, rate, review, and share this podcast, Get Down to Business, on iTunes, Google, Spotify, wherever podcasts can be found. And be sure to check out our sponsors, Tom Mirabali from healthplanchicago.com, for all of your health insurance or Affordable Care Act needs. Again, his website, healthplanchicago.com, and I encourage you to definitely get in touch with him. He's a great resource for everything relating to insurance. 630-863-3477. Quick break. We'll be right back.